India is known as the global diabetic epicenter of global diabetes epidemic. This is very unfortunate as we are seeing a large crowd being affected with diabetes, especially older generation is affected with type diabetes, and the younger ones have been recently diagnosed with type 1 recently, past 8 to 10 years it is being observed. But the count is very less, and that's why maybe the government or the focus is not too much on kids. But remember, type 1 diabetes is being shown and type 2 as well in kids is being seen. So it is high time that we consider to understand what it is, what are the symptoms, how do we take care of it when it happens to our kids, and any basic information that is needed to understand as a parent. Welcome to Tots and Moms. My name is Kavita, and first let's understand what is diabetes in common layman language. Diabetes mellitus is commonly called as diabetes or sugar in India, which is high blood sugar. Now our body, pancreas, produces a hormone by name insulin. This insulin is needed to convert the blood sugar to energy. Unfortunately, at some cases, this insulin is not produced enough, and in some cases, insulin is produced, but our body is not able to use it. So in such scenarios, it is called as a condition which is diabetes mellitus. And this, unfortunately, can cause nervous damage. It can affect our eyes, our vision, kidney, and mostly all of our organs. Let us understand the reason for diabetes in children. It can be genetic, passed on from parents or grandparents. It can be it is mostly due to unhealthy habits, that is sedentary lifestyle or no physical activity, obesity. It is also due to unhealthy food habits, junk food or excessive sugary drinks. If you can understand early signs of diabetes, it would be really helpful for us to ensure an early care. So type 1 and type 2 diabetes both have a similar symptom. It is frequent urinating, feeling thirsty, feeling hungry, feeling fatigued or tired, delay in healing in case they have any cut or sores, that gets delayed. Untimely weight loss, sudden weight loss, blurry vision. They may complain of not being able to see the board or book properly, read it properly, numbness or tingling sensation in hand and foot. These are all the symptoms. If you see any sign of it, please take them to doctor, get them tested for whatever recommendation the doctor gives, and that's the best way we can take care of our children at an early stage of diabetes, if at all it is there. I was mentioning about symptoms in type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Let us understand the difference between type 1 and type 2 diabetes. Type 1 is when your body is not able to produce enough insulin. Type 2 is when your body is not able to use the insulin. Type 1 is something which occurs at a very young age. Type 2 is something at an older age. But nowadays, children from 12 to 15 are also affected with type 2 diabetes. Another difference is cannot be prevented. Type 1 diabetes cannot be prevented. Type 2 diabetes can be prevented with a healthy lifestyle. Type 1 diabetes would need insulin therapy, and type 2 would need modification in lifestyle, and it can be well managed. How can you prevent your child from having diabetes? At first, type 1, I already said it is an autoimmune disease. It cannot be prevented. Type 2, we can do various things to prevent it for children, for ourselves, by ensuring to have a wholesome diet, a diet which includes greeny vegetables, all sorts of seasonal vegetables, fruits, dry fruits, millets, grains and pulses. Healthy home-cooked food is the ultimate answer. Then good amount of physical activity is needed. As we all know, it is corona, the COVID stuck era, and kids are not able to go out, but we can do our best by ensuring that we have them joined to some online yoga class. We can join to some dance classes or something. But ensuring inside these four walls, whatever we can do best for our children, for ourselves, that is highly recommended. And when things go fine, ensure your child picks up at least two sports and continues to have one for a life. I mean, when we talk to people who are abroad, they would introduce themselves by their name and then ask, what is that game you play? What is the game you play? Because it's very common there that they have one practice, at least in Australia, when I hear from my friends, they have to have one sports that they play. It is good for them to be physically and mentally fit. It is a stress buster, so it is highly recommended. Keep your kids away from junk food, sugary drinks, pizza, so much of outside food. We really bribe them. We tell them that you do this, I'll give you chocolate. You do that, I'll take you out for dinner. I mean, even if there is an occasion you want to go out for dinner, there are so many restaurants coming up with healthy food styles, food habits, food inclusions. Now, that is what we have to make a choice. Not that everybody is doing it, I also have to do it, right? Not at the cost of our health, our life, our kids' life. So it may be a cliche when somebody says you need to celebrate without having a sweet. It is possible. Why not cook something at home? And also the snack habit is changed. We used to roast peanuts and eat. We used to have a piece of dry mango, put chili powder and salt on it and relish it literally. Cucumber. These used to be our snacks, home-cooked paratha or something. But what is the snacking habit now? Please think about it. It is easy to bring in something which is unhealthy. Even packaged food now, you can see some healthy options. Start with it then. Start to read labels, how much of sugar is in it, how much of preservatives. All that can be dangerous and all that, checking it can be helpful. At last, few tips like keep them away from mobile. Gadgets are really good for their mental growth, and when the era is changing, this can be helpful for them in academy. But what about their health? Their health should not be compromised. So give it in a limited time, screen time or mobiles or gadgets in a limited period, and let them enjoy the world and be in the nature as much as possible. And a good sleep habit is really needed. Sleep at a certain time, wake up at a certain time. Weekend saga, all that needs to change. It used to be same. I mean, just because it is weekend, it's not that they will sleep late and get up late and do something. Maybe we can all, as a parent, you can take them to hiking, you can take them to a park somewhere. I mean, everyone is going to be affected by it one day if we don't change our lifestyle. And it is very important to have regular body checkup. We may feel that we are doing good externally, but it is important to check how our body is functioning. If you have a medical insurance, you can check that. You will have one free checkup every year. Most insurance companies do that these days. So please check that and utilize it well. I really hope that you like the information given here. Unfortunately, if you see any symptoms, taking your child to the doctor, and if your child is diagnosed to have diabetes, please stay strong. You are the pillar for him or her. You are the one who is going to safeguard them. Teach them how to live with it. Teach them how to get cured of it. Even type 2 diabetes is being observed these days. So please, as a parent, take a call, decide what is needed for your child. And in case such unfortunate things happen, let's learn to live with it happily. And I have few recommendation of videos. If you're a parent here, you would want to know these details. So I generally make these videos. White patches in kids, why does it happen? How you can prevent it? That video you can check. And intestinal worms, how can that also be prevented? Why does it happen frequently in certain children? What can be done to prevent it? These details are given in that video. Do check that. And I'm here because I run, the Tots and Moms brand, as you can see, the name of the YouTube channel is because of the food brand Tots and Moms Foods. I started that 7 years ago. And here we sell organic, chemical-free, USDA certified cereals, porridge mixes, instant mixes, cookies, pancakes. In that, we have used only millet and jaggery, no sugar, no artificial chemicals, preservatives used, anything like additives is not used. So please check that. That can be really healthy for your children. And for younger kids as well, we recommend not to give salt and sugar, which can be dangerous when they grow up. So all our foods meant for babies are without sugar, without any form of sugar. And dry dates powder, dry fruits powder are something that you can supplement them to have a healthy body. So please do check our shop, which is at shop.totsandmoms.com. Our products are also available at Amazon, FirstCry and Flipkart and many other websites for now. So do check and let us know if you have any question about this certain topic. I have spoken a layman language so that any parent can understand it. Definitely after that, when you go for treatment, when you go for diagnosis, the tests and other things, you will understand. And signing off, taking your leave now. Bye-bye.